Hello everyone and welcome back to the video. In today's video, we're going to be going over the top 5 reps of every single character in Smash Ultimate. Now, I did not make this list. This was all made by Bernard's Loop. I highly recommend you check him out on Twitter. He does a lot of very good work. And what he's done here is he's taken the time period of 2021 to current day, and he's compiled all the players in the world to make the top 5 of every character. Now, there are a couple things that could be wrong here. I think the main one would be people that just haven't gone to a ton of events, so they don't have any results, but we know they're incredibly talented, maybe from a lesser known region. Those are going to be some of the players that may be sitting out on the list, but overall, I think this is really well made. And it's not in order, by the way. It's not like Dark Wizzy is the best Mario in the time period, and Karaba's second best, now is third. It's just the top 5 Marios in no particular order, and let's get right into it. Now, unfortunately, you're not going to be able to mention every single player in this video because there is far too many, so we're just going to be staying mainly within the current meta, though. Of course, there are going to be some players that we are going to highlight outside of that, but starting off with Mario, I think our definitely main reps right now are Karama, and now I also think Snow could be added if you're just doing current day meta, but Sam P. Silver and Zenyu, they have a lot of results in 2021 era, as well as some in the 2022-2023, and Dark Wizzy, I feel like he's just been kind of a consistent threat all throughout it. For Donkey Kong, Hikaru is by far going to be your main rep. He's the only Donkey Kong player in the world to ever make top 8 at a major, aside from Akala at Battle of BC. Chunky Kong as well has had a bunch of really strong runs in the US, and all these players have done some serious damage in the bracket. Now, there has been no meta where it's kind to Donkey Kong. This character has always struggled, and he's always going to struggle, but that never changes the fact that his advantage state goes brazy. You can steal games, you can steal sets, you can even steal top 8s like Hikaru has done in the past. It is just extremely difficult. You need to be playing with the right fire and get the right kind of bracket. But the Donkey Kong players, they're always the kind of scariest ones to run into bracket because they have literally nothing to lose. You have Link as well. Now, this isn't a character that you see a ton at the top level, and this is something that I would wish to change because I love Link. This character is ridiculously good. They have a lot of very interesting tech. You have a lot of Link mains that are making waves. I want to highlight Vanessa as well, or Vince. He's been doing really well as of late. I just think he's an amazing player. You have Samus's. Now, Samus, you could have way more players for this list. This is only Icy Mist, Quick, Yara, Siski, and Tora, who are all relevant in today's meta. Like, all these players are still playing, getting some results. They have them in 2023. There is a lot of Samus players in this game. You look at Link players, none of these players have been able to make a top 8 in a major. You look at these players, half of them have. Like, it is very impressive how many good Samus players there are. You have Yoshi as well. Now, this is mainly spearheaded by Yoshidora. He's by far the best Yoshi in the world, but there are other Yoshi players who have had success. Swords is very good. J-Mafia is very good. Ron's made a big return. Blue Sky is always a good one. There's a lot of Yoshi players that are good, but Yoshidora is clearly the crown jewel of the Yoshi character. Like, it's not even close. Next up, we're going to have Kirby, and I don't know how some of these Kirby players are getting the placements that they are. It is actual insanity, because Kirby is an interesting character to me. He actually hits fairly hard. He has some very nice tilts. His air state is pretty good, but he is so slow. Like, so slow. It really doesn't seem like something that you could make work, in my opinion, but these 5 Kirby players clearly have made it work. I was more familiar with Zhejiang, but when I looked at the other players' resumes, it's all extremely impressive. Like, it's impressive for normal people to get these results, and they're doing it on Kirby. Like, that's what the messed up part is. You have Fox next, which just has Light, Passeriman, ZD, Comet, Katarabe. These are all players that are going to be in the current meta right now. You have ZD mainly staying to the local level, but you have Light obviously being the best in the world. You have Passeriman and Katarabe fighting it out for that title of best Fox in Japan. You have Comet, who's a big up-and-comer in NA right now. Like, there's a lot of good Fox players out there, which makes sense because that character is broken. And speaking of broken characters, we have Pikachu with Esem, Niraz, Enkai, Shiny Mark, and H4. Now, Niraz and Enkai, they're kind of battling it out for the best Pikachu in NA, or not NA, EU. You have Esem, who unfortunately has lost the title of best Pikachu if you are an Esem fan. Not that he can't get it back, though, because he looked really good at CEO. Like, I have a lot of faith in him. Again, you have Shiny Mark as well, who obviously popped up super hard at Collision, is an amazing player. H4, who won a really big Japanese region. Like, all the Pikachu players are finally starting to make waves again, which I am super happy about because that character is broken. You have Luigi, you have Elegant there, you have Lugi, Waka, Gaia, Yama, Noxion. All 4 of these players are in contention for the best Luigi in the world right now. Like, Luigi is one of the most highly contested characters in the game, which again doesn't make a ton of sense to me because I feel like this is the meta that would absolutely destroy him, but the Luigi players, they're making it work. You have Ness with Gak, Sen, Syrup, Pew, and Itadon. Now, all these Ness players are insane. I would say Gak is definitely the number 1 Ness. The number 2 Ness, though, I think there's a lot to debate for it, but Gak, he is crazy. He has some top 3s in tournaments that just do not make sense. You have Captain Falcon. All of these Falcon players, I would say, are in contention for number 1. I'd say the strongest one would definitely go to Jogabu, though, but I think Andrik has some really good resources. Karage's had some good tournaments. Fatality and Sean can pop off sometimes, especially Sean, but right now, I would definitely give it to Jogabu. Next up, you have Jigglypuff. Base Mage is definitely going to be your main rep of the character, but Senra has recently beaten Akala. Now, it was at a local, and he lost the run back, but still, he beat Akala with Jigglypuff. Like, that is pretty insane. You have Hungrybox, who beat Base Mage in the Ditto, Cannon Red, and Arikar, all these staples of the character. Like, there is so many good Jigglypuffs out there for no reason. I feel like they're only getting better, which, again, they shouldn't be in the current meta. This is a character meta where Jigglypuff should get destroyed, but they're making it work. And maybe it's because some of the bigger top tiers right now are a little bit more exploitable offstage, and that's going to be Jigglypuff's, obviously, main strong factor. So it's interesting to see how this character is going to continue on. You have Leaf, Umeki, Mudes, Ling, and Nuggets for Peach. Now, Umeki and Mudes are going to be your top two reps. I'm curious to see who people think is the number one rep, because you have Mudes with the peak, one of the biggest peaks of all time, with his second place at Genesis, but you have Umeki, who's made multiple top eights this year versus Mudes, his only top eight Genesis. Now, he has other good results. He has a bunch of regional wins. He also did really well at Summit, got a couple of good wins there. So it doesn't tell everything not getting to the top eight. But overall, Umeki is a little bit more consistent, I would say. Though both players are fairly inconsistent because that's just how Peach works. The character is very hard to be consistent with at the top level. You have Bowser now. 90% of Bowser's results recently have been coming from Hito. He has been carrying that character on his back. But Makuru, I've been very impressed by him. Leon sometimes pops off. Gogeta sometimes pops off. You have Polytopia, who sometimes does really well. But Hito is definitely going to be your main rep of the character. Though all the other ones can cause some serious damage to the bracket. I think Bowser is one of the best upset characters in the game. It's just really hard to make runs with them. Next up, you're going to have Ice Climbers. Now, 90% of the attention is going to go to Big D, and it should, but the Japanese Ice Climbers are also crazy. You have Harrison, you have Fuwa, you have Petari, Apple as well. He's not Japanese. He's a really good Ice Climber player from NA that I feel like doesn't get enough credit because he used to play a bit of Steve, but then he just popped off super hard with Ice Climbers at a tournament. I forget the one, but shouts him for that. Big D, though, he is still going to be your main rep, which does make sense. I mean, that run at Summit is literally incredible, plus a couple other good runs that he has. You have Sheik, which is Void, Rock, Sylph, Mr. R, and I'm. Now, I'm is definitely the best Sheik in the world right now, but Sheik's a bit of an interesting topic because Void, if he started playing super hard, maybe he could take it. Rocks, if he was able to travel, maybe he could take it. Mr. R, kind of the same thing. If he was able to travel, maybe he would take it. I feel like the Sheik title, it goes to I right now, but there's a lot of players that could potentially take it. I think WebJP is another one that could get added to this list very soon. He's been doing very well, but curious to see who takes that title going into the next year. Our next handful of characters haven't been having as much success in the overall meta of Smash Ultimate, but that's just because they aren't great. Zelda's a character that's never really been good, though all the Zelda players have been making some pretty big upsets here and there. They haven't been able to make it into a super deep run at a major yet. Dr. Mario's only really had that run from Super Pseudo, at least at the major level, which is a crazy run, by the way. And we've had some other good placements from players like Shisho, Bacon, Jazzar, Winder. They're all having good results, but that run from Sumo Pseudo is by far the crown jewel. You have Pichu as well, and I think Neatone is probably the best rep of that character. And unfortunately, it looks like he is shifting his focus more towards Diddy Kong. So the Pichu players may be struggling a little bit. But also, just last weekend, or rather this weekend, two Pichu players were able to top 8 some pretty big regional events in Drybee and Black Twin. So the hope for that character is not completely died out. You have Falco as well, who has Masa and Tilde, which I would say are the top two reps, but they don't really go to a ton of stuff. And sometimes Matsunabe, who is a big up-and-comer right now, pop up. Larry Learnfield will do that as well. They're people that you definitely can't out of majors, but they don't always make it to the top. You have Marth, which has some very weird results because I feel like Marth players are going to get more upsets and they're going to get deep runs just because of the nature of the character. And someone like Ignaz is never someone you want to run into a bracket. Like, that's actually incredibly scary. I feel like Lucina's kind of the contrary. You're going to make deeper runs, not as many upsets, but when you have someone like Proto Bonham kind of running with that character, you don't really need as many upsets. Now, they've been a little bit more quiet in 2023 just because Proto Bonham hasn't been as active, but the other Lucina players have been doing pretty well. Mr. E specifically has actually been doing really well this last season, so Lucina results are pretty good. You have Young Link as well. Now, I'd say the only Young Link player out of this top five that I would maybe switch around is I'd put Kobe in there. I don't know for who though, because I say all these Young Link players are in contention for the best Young Link in the world. The only one who actually top aided at a major level is going to be Suinoko. But if you look at someone like a Super Semi, like a Skittles, they're all amazing players. And I'm just thinking in recent terms, of course, there have been other top eights. Toast has been able to get some top eights at major performances. We have recently Kobe being able to win a very big regional at Cirque du CFL. So there's a lot of Young Link results that it's really tough to pick the top five. Like, honestly, all those players are in contention for number one. Now, Mewtwo and Ganon are characters that don't have a ton of success at the top level. With Mewtwo losing their best rep, there is kind of a void that I feel like needs to be filled that hasn't quite been filled yet, but I'm curious to see who's going to pick up that title of best Mewtwo. For Ganondorf as well, I'm not actually sure who the best Ganon is. I think right now it's probably between Major or Hikachan, but Rickles is always a major threat. Ganon's just a character that it's really tough to see who's the best one, because most of the time the Ganon players, even if they are the best Ganon in the world, aren't going to be making super deep runs because they are limited. Though there are a couple big upsets that the players have made in the past. You have Roy, who hasn't been doing as well in 2023, but before that, 2022, 2021, amazing character, putting in a lot of work from players like Cola, Goblin, Hikaru. I mean, Flo and Alice, they've all popped off at times. It's Roy players not even this list that have done well. Roy, a very common character, not as successful in 2023, but still pretty relevant. And then you have Crom, who is not relevant at all. Now, you do have Lancelot going super hard this last weekend, getting second place at a B-tier regional, but outside of that, Chrom is not a character you're seeing get a lot of results, especially after Mr. R dropping him. And then you have Game & Watch, who's been having a ton of success, especially recently with Mia and Meister doing incredibly well. Monty's really good. Kayra's really good. Reggie's really good. Reggie. There's so many amazing Game & Watch players out there, and there's only going to get more and more as people start to realize, okay, this character is like top 10 broken, because I feel like people didn't realize that till recently. Next up, you're gonna have Meta Knight. Now, Meta Knight's best results are done by far with Abadongo, but he has been using a bunch of other characters with the run, so it's hard to say who the best solo Meta Knight is. I want to lean a little bit towards Ye. He's been doing incredibly well when he actually does attend events. We unfortunately don't get to see him a ton, but I think Meta Knight's a very interesting character in the meta because he's so polarizing in one direction. He's very limited in his neutral game plan. He's kind of linear there, but once he gets his hands on you, Meta Knight becomes insanely strong, so curious to see that character's progression. You have Pit, who has been dominated heavily by Zachary. Like, Zachary has put this character on his shoulder big just because he's better than most people he's playing against, but the other pit players have made some big waves. I think Raze has done some serious damage to the character. Shiny Mark has a notable pit secondary as well, so I don't think Pit is a super great character, but I also don't think that they're incapable of making upsets because it is still Smash Ultimate. You have Zero Suit, which is still going to go to Mars. I feel like that's going to go to Mars till the end of time, but I think Doorstop stepped up recently. I think Shoe stepped up recently. They've been looking very impressive. Choco, Night of Sharp are always staples of the character. For Wario, it's again gonna be mainly Gluttony, but Huto, Crepsolet, Loaf, Jordan, they've all been stepping up recently. Vayne, very impressive looking. There's always gonna be one dominant rep of the character, but I feel like it isn't over-encompassing like it used to be. It's like Mars is the only Zero Suit. It's not like Gluttony is the only Wario. While they are still the main reps, they're not gonna be the sole reps, which I think is always gonna be. You'd have Snake, speaking of not having a sole rep, which has like 30 people that you can put in it. We're not even gonna talk about it because there are so many reps you can put in the Snake, but all those players are amazing. Ike, on the contrary, not as popular, but you actually have a lot of Psych players or other Ike players having a lot of success. Psychot's been looking really good. Yes, it's had some incredibly crazy runs in Japan of all places. I feel like that's the hardest place for Ike to succeed, but he has made it work. I think Ike is a character that's not going to get better in the meta. I think he's going to stay where he is. I think the only way I can see Ike having a little bit of use is maybe get some counterpick. I think Ike as a counterpick isn't terrible, especially against a character like Game Watch, but the people that have committed to solo mating Ike have somehow gotten some pretty nice results with him. Next up, you have Pokemon Trainer, who seems to be like a dying breed, but I think Noi's been making a lot of waves recently. If you're a PT fan like I am, I highly recommend you keep your eye out on him because he'll have a run once in a while. Once Quid returns, he can do great stuff. Atolie is starting to pick up the character again. Beast and Puppe, whenever they attend majors, do make things happen. Pokemon Trainer is a character that I still think is very, very good and I want to see more of. Next up, you're going to have Diddy Kong, who is severely popular at the top level. You've had a ton of results from this character, and even though Tweak is definitely the main rep, you are going to have other Diddy Kong players that have been having a lot of success. Kind of like I mentioned earlier with Zero Suit and Wario, they are people that are going to have one sole rep, but there's a lot of players beneath that that are doing a ton of work. You have Lucas, who I feel like it's just this like undiscovered tech character that one day will top 8 a major and the next day they'll win a major. It's going to be a rapid improvement for Lucas, the one person that is able to harness that tech and discover it. Until then, we haven't seen anything super crazy. I'd say the best one that we have to date is Regulo's run at SmashCon, which is unreal, but we haven't seen the character break into a top 8 yet. Again, big emphasis on yet, because I definitely think it is something that can happen. We'll just have to wait and see. You have Sonic as well, which is a very popular character at the top level. Sonic is definitely going to be your best rep, but Takai has been doing really well. Wrath, when he goes to events, is amazing. Pelly is going to be EU's best Sonic. You have Ken, who is using a bit of Sephiroth and Sonic, but still his Sonic is very, very good. And then on the other hand, you have a character like King DDD, who we haven't been seeing have a ton of success at the top level, though they have been able to make a couple upsets. That's mainly what the heavy characters are going to be doing. They're not going to be able to make the super deep runs, but they're going to be able to make the harder upsets because they are more unorthodox and they are so swingy in their game plan. You have Olimar with, again, a lot of reps at the top level, notably DeBuzz and Shuton being your main two reps who haven't been playing the character as much, but they still do keep it on the roster, which I think is important. Olimar is still a great character and there's no real reason to drop him. Also, I just wanted to point it out, but Nitox has also made a 9th place run at Call SL with Lucas, so clearly the character can work at the top level when played correctly. They have some crazy tech, but it's really hard to operate. Lucario is a character that's also been having a lot of success in the recent meta. The harder that you hit, the better that you're going to be doing. And Lucario is a character that once he gets your hands on you, when he has the aura, hits you insanely hard. We've been seeing Armadillo have a bunch of amazing wins, specifically at Battle of BC. You have Polynomius getting an upset over Bloom Forever. Like, these players have been getting a lot of very good wins. Gotcha P is able to beat Zomba when he's in Japan. Like, Lucario players, again, they're not always making the super deep runs because the character is extremely volatile, but the upsets are definitely with them. You have Rob, who is still represented by Zachary. Zomba's definitely going to be the best replicate character right now. Then you have MK, Big Boss, Anathema, and Wadi. Zomba is looking insane with this character. It finally feels like he has all that tech skill down. His patience is back. He's not as nervous when he's playing. He doesn't give up as many groovy habits, and he just looks collected and insane. Like, I'm very happy watching Zomba play right now. Seems like peak Rob, and like we're getting pretty close to that for a lot of characters. I feel like you have Toon Link as well with a bunch of reps that are doing well at the top level. I think Japan plays this character a lot more than everyone else. You have Sigma level 1, Manzuko. There's a couple other players you could add to that list. You have Aang and Jojo Tohoku, who are the best reps outside of Japan. I think other players you could add. I think Suna's a really good Toon Link player. But next up, you have Wolf. Wolf, you're going to have, ouch, makes sense. Atoriye makes sense. Masha makes sense. Jackal makes sense. Orion makes sense. Wolf is a very upsetting character. There's a lot of people you could probably put into this list. He's really popular. I think this is a good 5 for this pick, though. You have Villager as well. Shouts to Bobby Wasabi for getting on that list, even though he did retire. You have Kept as well, who I would say is definitely the biggest rep of the character, though Javi on Earth had appeared where he was doing incredibly well as well. You have Mega Man, who isn't a character that isn't as successful anymore, but I still think he's very good. Trim has results sometimes. Kamehameha will always whip it out. Piedmont and MPG have popped off super hard. Same thing with Repo. Mega Man's a character that's made some pretty deep runs in the past, but he doesn't do it all the time. Next up, you have Weefood, who I feel like has actually a decent amount of results that people don't really talk about, especially in Jelly. He's been able to win some pretty big regional events in Japan, so shouts to him for that. Weefood, I think, is a pretty nice character. Deep breathing is just insanity, but of course, you're not always going to have access to that. Rosalina is hard carried by DeBuzz. He gets so many reps with this character. While there are other good results from Rosa, DeBuzz just does insanely well. You have Little Mac, and Little Mac's a bit of a weird one because the character has different standards, right? When someone gets 17th at a major with Little Mac, they're the best player in the world, and I'm not over exaggerating at all. Some of these Little Mac results are insanity that they did it with Little Mac, but in the grand scheme of things, they don't look as impressive. But you gotta remember the things that these guys are doing, the upsets that they're getting with Little Mac, it's insane. Pina especially, he does God's work with this character. Greninja is a character I don't think we're seeing have as much success anymore. I feel like that was a little bit more earlier on to the game, though. Europe and Japan are still doing fairly well with the character. You don't see them as much in NA. Not that they've completely disappeared, though. There are a couple good reps here and there, just not as much as you used to see. Next up, you have Politeia, who is a very popular character, next to Pac-Man, who is also a very popular character. All these people have had main success. Pac-Man does have that main representation of T, whereas Politeia, I feel like it's a little bit more divided, though. I'd say right now, Chase is definitely the best replica character, but all the Pac-Man players and Politeia players have had a bunch of good results throughout all of Smash. They've just been doing extremely well. They're two popular characters, so it doesn't make sense. Robin's a character not as popular. I want to highlight Ban in anime because he is crazy, and not many people know about him because he is from a smaller region. Extremely talented player. If we ever see them start traveling, I think they could cause some serious damage. Shulk as well. I feel like Shulk will pop off at one tournament. I mean, this weekend you had Elijah going super hard, getting top 3 at Battle of Z. And then you had Gyarados King doing really well at Rising Grad. You've had Kome do really well at some big events. All the Shulk players, I feel like they have these times where they pop off super hard. And that's just how Shulk is going to work as a character because he is so hard. Once you get that good bracket, you get that good run, you could do some really dangerous things. You have Bowser Jr. as well, who feel like has always been a character that will just get an upset randomly. And all the Bowser Jr. players will do this. Yoda Cage does it, Ketchup does it, Sweshy Slime, TM7 Zap, and they'll all do it throughout different periods of the game. It just feels like at one point, oh yeah, this is the Bowser Jr. who has most recently popped off super hard, and they'll just kind of trade that position back and forth. Dokkan as well. Embo Z is crazy. Sekio Dog is crazy. Fawn, Raito, Jagabata, like all these guys are insane. They do some really good work with Duck Hunt. Like when I watch them play, they make me think that Digba or Big Duck Hunt fan is actually spitting. Like they have some crazy combos with the can, with the frisbee. The frisbee especially is where we're going to be getting the main usage out of Duck Hunt. But I think the character is still bad, but people are able to put in some pretty good work with it. Now you have Ryu, who again is dominated by Asima, but all the other Ryu players, they actually have some pretty good reps. I think Ryu is a very well-represented character. Same thing for Ken. I would definitely give the main rep to Takara. Also, shouts to Vendetta for being in both categories. I think he's one of the only players in the world to actually achieve that for two characters. And I know they are similar characters, but it's still pretty impressive. You have Cloud, who isn't super carried by Spargo, but they are because Spargo is getting some ridiculous results. But the other Cloud players are still doing some really good stuff. Enhanced PV has been doing really well. Yoshi's really good. Nico's popped up super hard. Same thing with Azrael. But Spargo's obviously going to be your over-encompassing factor. You have Korn. The main battle of Korn is definitely between Shattuck and Neo right now. But if MKLeo starts picking up that character seriously again, which it looks like he might after Wave Dash, it's going to be very interesting to see if Neo and Shattuck are able to hold that title. And the answer for that is going to be probably not, but we have to see. And then for Bayonetta, your main rep's definitely going to be Bloom Forever Lima. But Despade, I think Frog's been really good. I think Tam has been really good. They've all had tournaments where they popped off. Despade especially, I think he's someone that has been in radar. And there's a bunch of Bayonetta players that have been having a lot of success. This is definitely a late game character, as we can see from Lima and Bloom's results, because they've been popping off super hard. onto the ultimate characters. Inkling's going to be a character that suffered a lot. They were very good in the early meta and fell off pretty hard, but still, Inkling players have actually been able to get some pretty good results. Shiryuki's been able to get some top eights as well, so shout out to Inkling players. They're still able to defend. I mean, even recently, Space was able to get his win at Smash Contest Dohkeemi, and even though he did use a combination of Aegis and Inkling, the Inkling still definitely did help him to get that dub. You have Ridley, who's had a bunch of random upsets. Smub, Mezcal, Momon, Nair, Raijin, never players that you want to run into. It's Momon from Japan, by the way. The other Momon is a European player who plays Fox and Luigi. You have Richter, who I would say that T3 Dom is the best rep of the character, but I think that Squid Plumber does have the highest high where he was able to top 8 glitch, so huge shouts to him for that. Noxombro, Yosifu, Trigger, they've all also had some pretty good results as well. You have K-Roll now. In my opinion, I think Kirby Kid is the best K-Roll or Lukewarm, but there's a lot of very good K-Roll players. Brewhouse had some good results. Ball is one that you can never really throw out, even though he isn't in this top five. I think he's amazing. So K-Roll is a character that has gotten some upsets in the past. You have Isabelle as well. I would say that after Jaka's recent run at Smash Contest Dohkeemi, I would give him the title of best Isabelle, though obviously one run is not over-encompassing. Axel's done really well at some events. Mr. Zircon, B-Rush, Nier, they've all had some good results, but I would be leaning towards Jaka right now. Incineroar definitely goes to Skyjay. Like, it's not close, but the other Incineroar players, they've actually made some pretty good runs. I feel like don't get credit enough just because Skyjay's runs are so, like, insane. Next up is going to be Piranha Plant, and after Brood's run at Umabor, we definitely haven't seen this character have a lot of success, but we've had Lucky do pretty well. Dimitri recently did pretty good at Battle of BC. The character still has some results, but it's nothing near that peak that was hit so long ago. You have Joker as well. Now, with Leo picking up the character again, he's probably going to be the best Joker, but even if Leo and Zachary don't fully pivot back to Joker, I still think that this character is going to do fine. Tsubaki's been doing amazing. Omega and Lemon are really good players that I think are going to continue improving, so even if your two top dogs don't pick up Joker, I still think the character is going to get results. You have Hero as well. Akka definitely having the peak of the character, but Sparko, Beastfold, Paul, Kamisuka is definitely an up-and-comer. Vivi's a really good one as well. There's a lot of hero players that have made runs. I think Leon as a secondary hero is also a pretty dangerous one, but Akka, I would say, is your main rep. For Banjo, the best Banjo in the world by far is Toriguri, and in some offense, the other Banjo players, they're all amazing. They've all had good runs. Toriguri is something else with this character. Like, he is genuinely incredible. You have Terry, who is an underrepresented character, in my opinion, still, but you have Riddles, who obviously had a lot of work with him. EZS has recently been doing really well. Andres FN sometimes pops up super hard. Lesudo and Mustaine are really good players with it as well. Riddles is still going to be your best rep, but I think there are other really good Terrys in the world. I still think Terry is a character that is underutilized. Like, he is insanely good. Next up, you have Byleth, which does have Spargo, which is just kind of showing how crazy Spargo actually is. Like, the fact that his Byleth that he uses just to regals for fun is top five in the world is pretty insane. Obviously, Leo's going to be your number one. I think the player that I would maybe sub in for Spargo would be Justin Byleth, but to be honest, I'm not as familiar with the character. And then you have Minmun, which is definitely spearheaded by Proto Bonham, but Doramiki, with his recent run, may be looking to take that title. Omatsu's had some good runs. Justice and DeBuzz have popped up from time to time, though I don't think that DeBuzz's Minmun is going to be super prominent in the future. Steve, this is a very popular character. A lot of people you could slot in here. I'm happy to see Yanni actually getting on there because he is one of the OGs. Then you have Akala and Odin obviously being your top two. Jake's been doing really well for a long time. Quandale as well whenever he goes stuff. And there's a bunch of people that could get added to the list and probably will get added to the list. I mean, Mia probably could with his secondary Steve, but it's a popular character. You're going to expect a lot of people. It isn't too surprising. Sephiroth, your main two are going to be Tweak and Ken, but M4E and Strix are some two up-and-comers. Ned did a lot better earlier on in the meta, but I still think he is a player that is a serious threat that you need to look out for. You have Aegis, which is obviously going to be Spargo and Leo, I would say, are your top two reps. But Cosmos had periods where he was incredible. Shutone as well sometimes pops up super hard. Space is another one that's done really well. I mean, I said it earlier, just recently running a pretty big regional. Aegis, another character that's going to be extremely popular top level. Speaking of character extremely popular top level, you have Kazuya. Riddles obviously going to be your main one. T has had some really good results, though. Taric's really good. Ferps is amazing. We just don't get to see a ton of him. Axiom has popped off super hard at some tournament. Next up, you have Sora. And as you can see, the character isn't super popular at the top level, despite being so good, because you have Zachary on the list, despite him only playing the character in one tournament. Now, to be fair, he did win the entire tournament, and it was a major, but like, whatever. Kamehameha is definitely going to be your best rep, but Deathspade, Unleashed, Koba, Kira, they sometimes have popped up super hard. Again, Deathspade is a player that you need to look out for. He's continually improving. Major threat. Me Brawler. Now, I think the Me Brawler list is going to change. There's no disrespect to any of the Brawler players. I think they're all very good. I just think that people still don't realize how amazing this character is. afterwards, and we're going to have a wave of people picking him up and doing really well, even if it is as a secondary, which a lot of people on this list do use him as. I just think Meat Brawler is a character that is still very underutilized. And now for Meat Gunner and Meat Swordsman, not so much. Meat Gunner, I think your best rep is going to be Copy Tuxedo for a very long time. He is incredible with that character, like genuinely amazing, though other people have been able to get some good results with it. And then Meat Swordfighter, really difficult character to have a lot of success with. He's just not super great, but Shisho has been having some pretty good results here and there, and other Meat Swordfighters have been able to make some decent upsets. It is Smash Ultimate. Even if your character is weak and limited, you could kill cause some serious damage in any bracket. And I thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If there's anything that I left out, a player that I missed, or something that I just got wrong in this video, I'm sure it happened at least once. Please let me know down below. The sport has been absolutely unreal lately. Thank you guys for everything. Be sure to sub and all that yada yada. And I will see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.